Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at the new expression wrinkles feature with the iClone 8.2 and Character Creator 4.2 updates, which enhances the visual quality of facial animation for CC3 Plus characters. We'll go through some of the content included in this update along the way. In the character subfolder under Actor, you'll find all of your embedded character models for CC4. You'll also notice now that several of the actors have been updated with the small wrinkle icon on the top left of the thumbnail, indicating that they include wrinkles. You can also see this by right-clicking and going into Content Info. You'll also notice that under Facial Profiles, there are some new ones that are suitable for wrinkles, in particular for character smiles. And also more under Expression Wrinkles for our main embedded characters and also a neutral one. You can see the wrinkle type by going into Content Info. General live wrinkle types will adjust the wrinkle texture in real time as they're not yet baked, whereas the individual or flattened type has the wrinkle maps already baked, so only the intensity can be adjusted. We'll have another tutorial that goes into more depth on this feature. In the updated CC4 folder, you'll find a wrinkles feature demo project which you can deconstruct and test yourself.
Sometimes you look at the wrong person not because you are jealous, but because you are kind. Instead of being disappointed about where you are, think optimistically about where you are going.
There are also some updated animations categorized to test out different aspects of the wrinkles feature individually, allowing us to see the results more clearly. Okay, so that's the basic content covered. Let's look at the Expression Wrinkles tab now, which you can find in the Modify panel. If you check the Activate checkbox, it will automatically apply a neutral wrinkle template to your character, as long as it's updated to a CC3 Plus profile. In this particular case, Camilla has her own embedded one, so let's apply that instead. There are three different wrinkle test animations that you can apply to your character to test out the results. Here you can see the neutral performance female one applied, and how the results look with or without the wrinkles feature applied. Wrinkles can naturally be seen more strongly around the forehead and eyebrows, as well as the nose and around the mouth. This profile tends to have the strongest effect around the eyebrows, and if we zoom in there and adjust the overall influence slider, you can see how it affects the wrinkles appearance. If you want to go into more detail and adjust the strength for individual facial regions, you can do that by selecting specific areas of the reference image below. The strength slider determines the level of effect on the selected area, while the AO and crease line sliders determine the intensity of the shadows between the wrinkles, which can make them appear to have more or less depth. Redness is a very subtle parameter that slightly affects the appearance of wrinkle tenseness, while normal is very similar to strength, except it affects the normal map specifically. Once you've found a level you want, you can click on the Set as Default button to save it. Keep in mind that no matter how many adjustments you make, you can always reset back to those saved values, and you can also simply set everything to maximum with the click of a button as well, both for the individual and overall regions. We can also use the speed slider to set the speed at which wrinkles appear in a specific area. You'll notice here that with a higher speed value, the wrinkles are faster to appear, and a bit slower to disappear once an expression goes back to normal. This can be useful in certain scenarios to help emphasize expression intensity. Since the wrinkle feature applies in real time for all character facial animation, it is compatible with iClone's arsenal of powerful animation tools. The face key editor is used to manipulate individual facial muscles in detail, but also has expression templates as well as individual blend shape sliders, mainly used for frame-by-frame refinement or blending. The face puppet tool allows you to control expression templates and individual features with your mouse movement for quick yet smooth results. For even more real-time control, you can also use facial motion capture with the Motion Live plugin and an Apple phone, Of course, the wrinkles feature goes right along with it. Finally, you also have the AccuLips tool, which allows for exceptionally accurate automatic lip syncing from scratch that is easy to combine with facial expressions using the aforementioned tools. Naturally, you can easily import all of this together into Unreal Engine 5, Unity, and Blender using their respective auto setup tools, which are free to download via the ReIllusion site. The Wrinkles feature also automatically adjusts itself to match other character skin aspects, such as diffuse color, where it will match any changes you want to make to the character's skin color. If you find the skin tone is different from the wrinkle color, simply click the Update Wrinkle Texture Color button. Naturally, this feature is also fully compatible with the SkinGen skin editing system in Character Creator, so you don't need to worry about face paint, makeup, and other skin elements like freckles, sweat, or blushing getting in the way. You can apply different wrinkle expression templates based on the personality and effect that you want to go for with your particular character. Finally, if you have a stylized CC3 Plus character with a more cartoon-like style, you may want to check out the Stylized Wrinkle Pack available in the Content Store, which contains a number of different dynamic wrinkle style templates, both for realistic and toon style characters. The realistic ones can be used to enhance the personality of more realistic-looking characters, while the stylized templates are better suited for exaggerated or toon-like characters. You can check out the link in the description to learn more about it. That's it for this tutorial, guys. Stay tuned for more detailed tutorials on how you can use wrinkles and other features to enhance the visuals of your character's facial animation. I'll see you in the next video.